Hey guys, it's Claire from Clairified Creations. Welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about what not to bring to college. Most people talk about what you need to bring to college, but a lot of people leave out what not to bring. So don't worry, I have you covered. Let's get straight into it. One quick little addition, I'd really appreciate it if you guys would subscribe to my channel because I have a goal of hitting 1,000 subscribers at the end of June because I'm planning on doing a massive giveaway. Number one. You don't want to bring too many decorations. I personally made this mistake and I brought a ton of fairy lights and just random little knickknacks that I thought would look great in a dorm room. But honestly, they didn't serve a purpose and I hardly used them. For my lights, I think I maybe turned them on 3 times in the entire time I was at the dorm. Mid-semester, I had to switch dorm rooms because of roommate differences and then I never put them up. So it was kind of a waste of $15. So save yourself those $15 because I'm sure you'll need them and you'll definitely find other ways to repurpose that money. Throughout this video, I'm going to talk a lot about what you need to bring and some other alternatives in case you do want to bring the thing I'm mentioning. You always want to put practical over pretty first. Being practical is something I wish I had more of. I think every freshman is going to be super excited to move into a new space and that is why we all spend a little bit too much money on decorations, so save yourself that time and money and heart. Number two, don't bring too many decorative pillows. Now a lot of us are going to go overboard and we're going to buy 15 different pillows for our bed, trying to achieve that Pinterest look. You know what I mean, with the beautiful furry throw pillows all over the bed, making it nice and cozy. I brought 3 pillows. Now I know that's not very many. You've also got to think about your bed size. Most likely you guys are only going to have a twin XL. And let me tell you, that is not a very big bed. It is so small. It's like this big. So that is why I recommend maybe bringing 4 pillows max, 1 for you to sleep, obviously, and then the other 2 or maybe 3 if you really want to go out there and get that third extra pillow on top of the other one. Number 3, expensive anything. Cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching. Leave those precious mementos at home. Don't bring pure gold to college. Or really any jewelry. Throughout my entire freshman year, I touched my jewelry box and I only brought maybe 10 pieces of jewelry, some bracelets, a couple necklaces, really the bare essentials, and I didn't wear them. It's kind of useless to bring really anything that is a meaning. I mean, you should look presentable and everything, don't get me wrong, but it's not a fashion statement. You're there to learn. A quick little side story, I saw one girl bringing in a safe to college. She actually bought a full size, well not a full size, but a very large size safe that was about the size of a microwave and stored it in her closet. Personally, I think that's a little bit crazy. You don't need a safe if you're not gonna bring those precious valuables. Unless you're planning on storing over $10,000 in cash, I don't think you really need it because you really shouldn't be bringing that much anyways. If you're having trouble deciding whether or not you want to bring that $1,000 purse to college, let me tell you, just don't do it. Number 4, don't bring your entire wardrobe. I know that a lot of people already tell you this, don't bring too many clothes, but it's really true. I only brought about 20 pieces of clothing that fit on my hangers. I bought a pack of 20 velvet hangers and I limited myself to that. Thank goodness, but I think I could have actually packed a little bit more. Don't pack every single high school shirt. You're probably not gonna wear high school shirts. For me, it was just a little bit weird, especially since you kind of closed that chapter at high school graduation. Now you're moving on to a fresh school. Don't be that kid that wears other people's university colors. That's just weird. From personal observation, I wouldn't recommend it. Another thing you want to be mindful of is bringing too many decorative items. So decorative flowy tops or dresses, really fancy formal clothing. I never once touched my fancy clothes except for honors convocation, which was one of the first days of school. And besides that, they had no purpose. They just stayed in my closet looking there, collecting dust with all the sad dust mites because I never dusted. Number 5, I know that this one is kind of debatable and it really depends on your living situation, mainly your bathroom situation. I brought, I think, 3 pairs of slippers and let me tell you, I didn't use them hardly at all. They also stayed under my bed collecting dust with all the other sad dust mites. Unless you guys are gonna have your own private bathroom or you think you're really gonna use them, I suggest leaving them at home because they're just more of a nuisance to have than a handy, helpful thing. I prefer using shower shoes or my flip-flops every time because we had a community style bathroom. It was more like a pod living situation going on there. I didn't think slippers were the most comfortable or the most practical because I didn't want to get my beautiful, soft, fuzzy slippers dirty with the bathroom floors. So I would really think about that. And if you guys really want to bring them, maybe only bring one, but don't bring more than one pair of slippers. Also, you need to be okay with getting them dirty. Number 6. Exercise equipment. You guys are probably going to have access to a really nice gym, at least your freshman year. There's a world-class gym just feet away from my dorm room, so I never used any workout equipment. I did bring a pair of dumbbells that were 5 pounds each. They sat at the top of my closet for the entire year. I thought I would use them, I thought I'd work out, but you're already getting enough of a workout walking to all of your classes, and then with the optional gym, it's not really worth it, so leave those at home for you to go and exercise with, and I'd suggest really taking advantage of the gym and all the amenities the school has to offer, because I unfortunately did not do that, and I really wish I had. The next thing I would recommend leaving at home is excess cleaning supplies. Now don't get me wrong, you should definitely clean, vacuum your floor. Do all the necessities to keep your space nice and tidy, but don't bring every single cleaning product there is out there. I know I had an entire drawer full of Clorox wipes, special technology wipes, all sorts of random cleaning supplies that I never used. It was very frustrating because that took up precious space and you do not want to have an entire drawer dedicated to useless things that you're not using. I recommend bringing a vacuum or a broom, definitely not both. If you guys do find yourself wanting to take all the cleaning supplies that you can possibly bring, a tip for this is to only bring smaller packs of this or split up the packs and leave some of it at home. You could put some of the Clorox wipes in a Ziploc baggie and just separate it based on that. That way you're not taking up too much space, but rest assured you'll have everything you need. Let's talk about laundry. Now, if you're planning on doing laundry at your school and you're more of a out-of-state student or you're not very close to home, definitely bring those Tide Pods. They will come in handy, but don't bring a pack of 500 different laundry items, you know, detergent, those little dryer sheets. You don't need all of that. Depending on how often you're planning on doing laundry, for me, I did it about once every 2 weeks, and I'm being generous. Sometimes I waited 2.5 weeks, and that was not advisable. Do not do that, guys. Don't put off your laundry for too long because it can really come back, and you will find yourself with literally zero clothes, especially if you only take 20 to begin with. I never did laundry at school. I think I did it maybe 4 times because I wanted to wash my sheets. It was so much easier to drive home and do my laundry here. That way, I knew that I would have a guaranteed washer and dryer for me, because laundry at school is sometimes a little bit frustrating, especially if there is a washer open but not a dryer open. My friend unfortunately ran into this issue where she had a washer and she washed her clothes, came back to put them in the dryer, and there were no dryers available. She had to spread all of her towels out into her entire dorm room, waiting for a dryer to be open, and then she had to go to class. Her room really smelled like wet clothes afterwards, so having that assurance is really comforting. Especially when you're at home, just lug back your laundry and you'll be good to go and rest assured. Additionally, I never had to worry about anybody stealing my clothes at home because at college, let me tell you, they will steal anything. And I didn't have this happen to me, but I've heard of stories where people would steal other people's clothes if they didn't come down right away and get their laundry out of the washer or the dryer. That's pretty sad, and I don't want that to happen to you guys. So if you are gonna do your laundry there, make sure you're watching it or setting a timer because you don't want to have stolen clothes. The next thing you should do is check with your school policies regarding appliances. I know a lot of schools will say no to toasters, candles, anything with a flame. At my dorm, the first day of school, we had a fire alarm because somebody didn't know how to use the kitchen and almost burnt the place down. We weren't allowed to bring anything with a flame, and we also couldn't bring electric blankets, which was very, very sad because I wanted an electric blanket. I had one, but that's not allowed. Number 10, excess stationery. A lot of us are going to think, oh, we're going to write letters, we're going to write postcards, we're going to need every single type of paper that we can possibly find, all the cute pens, everything to make our dorm that much more special and homey. Well, I thought the same way as well, and I ended up writing maybe 10 letters my entire year. Now, I'm not saying don't bring any stationery, because you're probably going to want to write letters. It's so precious to get a warming, heartfelt letter in the mail. If you guys would like to send me a letter, that would be very nice. I would be extremely touched. The next thing you're probably not going to have time for is making crafts or reading leisurely books. As I'm sitting behind me, I have an entire bookshelf full of books, and believe me, I wanted to bring almost all of them to college, but I knew I was there to study, and books would only be a distraction. It's probably not going to happen. You're more than likely going to have something to do at all hours of the day. Number 12, something I thought would be really useful for college, but it ended up being a flop, was a steamer. I sat my steamer in the drawer, and it was used one time. I ended up taking it home on Christmas break because I never used it. Guys, wrinkled clothes are a fashion staple. Don't let anybody else tell you otherwise. They are there to make you look good. You don't have to have perfectly crisp, tidy looking clothes. Throw on a shirt and you'll be good to go. Like I said earlier, you want to make sure you look okay, decent at least. But there's really no need to iron out all the fine lines and wrinkles of your clothes. Number 13, extra seating. I do recommend an ottoman, but I don't recommend maybe a full-size leather couch or a giant chair. That's going to take up way too much space, and your space is already really limited in the dorms. So don't do that. Don't bring a very giant piece of furniture. However, if you do want to invest in seating because you know that somebody might be coming over or you want a little bit more space, I highly recommend getting an ottoman with storage. That's the key, with storage. So that way you have a two-in-one situation going on there. You have extra seating and you have storage, which is always a great thing to have in college. Or you can get a foldable chair for when people come over and you can slip it underneath your bed, and that way it doesn't take up too much space. Other than that, don't get any other giant pieces of furniture because it'll just sit there and it won't be used, and you'll be really sad that you spent $500 on a chair that is never used. The last thing you're not going to want to bring to college is too many snacks. As freshmen, you guys are probably going to have a dining plan, and I know from experience that is definitely not fun. I really struggled with the food my freshman year. It was awful. Don't bring too many unhealthy snacks. You're more than likely going to have other options. You're going to want to eat out sometimes, or you can go to the dining hall and get some snacks there. All right, that's everything I have for you guys. I'll see you guys later. Bye!
Money, 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 money! Money, money!
Bracelets? No. Nobody's really gonna care how you look unless you do. I only bought?
Dusty dust.
Handy helpful thing. Handy helpful thing. Say that 5 times really fast. Handy helpful thing. Probably not both, so leave one at the home. There's a gnat. Gnat! We have a gnat problem in our house. Anything hot?
Duh.
Drawer. Why can't I think of the word drawer?
Drawer?
Drawer. And you know, you don't have to have perfectly crisp, clean clothes. Well, actually, you do have to have clean clothes. Man, that came out wrong. Or a sweeper. Sweeper? That's not a word. Sweeper? Sweeper. Broom! A broom. Brr.